Because I'm what you call a do that. I'm going to do that. That's like, a do that is like, I'm not one of those guys that walk down the street, right? You know, and women are like, oh my God, girl, you see that motherfucker? He's so fire. Ooh, God, I'd fuck him right now. That's not me. I'm going to do that. You got to get to know me. I make you laugh, see my bank account. You know, oh, I can do that.
What's up, everybody? I'm Nika Simone, the 6'2 diva from West Covina, and I'm here for Comedy Hype right now in downtown LA at Club Nokia for Guy Torry's Phat Tuesday comedy show. Man, it's going to be a great event. I can't wait for the show to start. We have Dion Cole, we have Steve Wilson, Tiffany Haddish, as well as DL Hughley, man, headlining the event. So many stars already in the building. We have Olden Pawnees, NBA player. We have Angela Bassett is here looking fine as I don't know what. Keith Washington, there's so many people here. Joe Torry, I can't even keep naming them out, you guys. Come join us. Watch us on the red carpet. ComedyHype.com. ComedyHype.com today, man. We're here on the red carpet, Phat Tuesdays, Nokia Theater with the big brother of Guy Torry, Joe Torry in the field. Man, how do you feel that it's, you know, for black comedy? For, you know, Bob had his show going over there, reciprocating from a guy, and now that they've shut that down, how does that for black comedy over there, at least at the Comedy Store?
I mean, well, before Bob, it was, you know, some other people.
Yeah.
I mean, and, you know, since Phat Tuesday shut down, my brother was doing it. No, it hasn't been the same. Phat Tuesday was, back then, was a lifesaver, was a chance to make it, and not a chance to die.
Comedy Hype. Guess who we ran into? Tim Owens. Shaq All Star doing her thing, running things over there. What's going on?
I'm getting ready for All Star and Super Bowl. Have two amazing lineups. I love Comedy Hype. They're always an advocate for us.
Why do you think Carmichael Show's doing so well?
I think it's doing very well because it's about real stuff. We're talking about real issues. Okay. We're not sugarcoating anything. And we're doing it in a funny, humorous way.
Okay. Family for real.
That's what black people talk about.
Get to the club, you walking that motherfucker like you a unicorn because you want everybody to see them shoes. Walk in here.
My son asked me to buy him some Beats by Dre headphones. I went and priced them up like them bitches was $400. I'm like, y'all ain't got no Beats by Soulja Boy?
Just ripped the stage. I love you, I want you to know. You already know I do.
You know I love you.
He's my comedy crush.
She's been doing it for a long time.
I'm trying to do my thing here with Comedy Hack.
That I've been doing for a long time. The funniest thing that I know.
I appreciate you for coming on.
Yeah,
I love you.
You're my girl, baby. Love y'all.
I read an article said having alcohol before bedtime can disrupt sleep, only for the motherfucker who didn't make it home drunk and horny. Because men get home, hey, girl, you sleep? It's too late. Too late? What the fuck are you, the mall? Well, is the food court open?
Leave me alone, I gotta go to the gynecologist in the morning.
You gotta go to the dentist, too?
ComedyHype.com, we're right here on the red carpet at Phat Tuesday's comedy show. But we got the, come on, legendary. DL Hughley, come on.
How you doing, sweetie?
No, I'm great now.
Good.
Like I said, it's the black and brown comedy get down. Right. Like the King's comedy was all for black people.
Right.
But now we have it where it's, you know, you got George Lopez. Well, I'm thinking of more brown. Who else? You know, Hispanic people.
Well, you know what? I think one thing about the tour is George was very careful in putting cats together that he had an affinity for and he worked with. And I think the metrics work out good in terms of length of time, affinity for each other, cats having a certain type of mindset. So I think it's brown and black is really the same thing. Everybody get pulled over by the police at the same time.
I appreciate you, man.
Thank you.
Good luck out there if you don't need it.
Thank you. Oh, everybody needs a little something. Thank you.
I'm at a comfortable age where I will admit to everybody in here that I will never go to jail because I'm a snitch. If you don't want the cops to know, don't do the shit around me because I will cooperate with the authorities.
We're here. Steve Wilson, ComedyHype.com. Phat Tuesday's on the on the red carpet with Steve Wilson, man, one of the co-hosts of DL Hughley Show. Just ripped the stage tonight.
Oh, did I?
I felt you did very
well. Well, thank you very much. I tried my best.
But doing your thing, how'd you feel tonight?
It was a great show. I love the energy in the room. Everybody came out for part two of the brand new Phat Tuesdays. I'm just happy about it. So, you know.
I'm wishing the best, especially, you know, coming from the comedy store and just branching into something new.
From the comedy store to Club Nokia. That's hot. That's hot. Yeah, that's hot. And it was packed, too, so Guy is doing it, y'all.
Stopping by.
Come on now. Come on now.
Look, oh, my gosh.
It's Christmas.
Every time.
There's people starving in the Compton. It wouldn't be if they knew her.
Esau McGraw.
Fancy-ass African-American.
Love this dude.
Nigerian.
Hilarious all over the place.
Uh-huh.
You coming back for that, too? Like, we here.
Yeah. I'll be back.
What do you think of the show so far?
I love the show. The show is dope. It's like Phat Tuesdays from sunset, and you take it and you multiply it by 10. It's like a lot of energy, you know what I mean? It's just a lot of fun.